Hi friends, how are you all doing? Till now, we saw many concepts regarding stocks and options. Today, I thought of covering a little bit about futures. Those who are not aware about stock or options, just check out this video that's appearing in your screen. Complete this video and then come to this futures video so that you can understand a little better. So we are going to do one-to-one comparison of stock, options and futures. We'll do apple-to-apple comparison. While doing this comparison, we are going to take only one perspective, that is buying. What if we buy a stock? What if we buy a call option? What if we buy futures? What are the advantages, limitations? What are the functionalities involved? Terminologies involved, all this. Come on, let's go right into our session. Before I explain about futures, first of all, we need to see the theoretical knowledge about futures. Futures is what? Future is also a derivative. Like option, future is also a derivative. When I say derivative, what does derivative mean? Like when the underlying, for example, if we take an option, SPY option, what is the underlying? The S&P 500 index. If the S&P 500 index increases, SPY options price will also increase. Similarly, if you take futures, the ticker symbol for S&P 500 futures is ES. So, if S&P 500 index increases, the value of futures will also increase. That is the meaning of derivative. Number one characteristic of futures is obligates the parties. If we buy a futures option or if we buy a futures on crude oil and if we are holding that futures till the expiry date, each crude oil futures contract, meaning we are taking control of 1,000 barrels of crude oil. So if you hold with that futures contract till the expiry date, you are bound to buy the 1,000 barrels of crude oil. Practical scenario, it may not happen. Broker will insist us to square off the position much in advance prior to the expiry date. But theoretically speaking, we are obligated. You can't say, I don't have a place to store the 1,000 barrels of crude oil. You are bound. You are obligated. That's what the theory says. We transact with different kinds of assets. What are those assets? I'll explain in the next slide. Futures is for a predetermined future date. We are entering into a contract with the seller to buy a specific asset for a specific future date and for a specific price. So we have different expiry, similar to option, even futures as well, we have different expiry. For S&P 500 futures, we have quarterly expiry, like September, December, March, June. So, for if I get into a futures contract for the September expiry month, for example, $3,423, I'm bound to buy the futures contract on that specific expiry date for this specific price. Right? So, what are the asset classes involved in futures? Like for stocks and options, it deals only with the stocks with specific companies. But here we can deal with commodities as well, like coffee, sugar, cotton. In case of energy, we can buy and sell crude oil, natural gas, and equity index. We can handle S&P 500 and Nasdaq. For foreign exchange, we can deal with euro, yen, dollar, and whatever the currencies available. Metals, we can aluminum, zinc, lead, etc. We can deal with different wide variety of asset classes, not confined to only companies and stocks to specific companies. It's some future terminology. I took two examples here. ES is the ticker symbol, future ticker symbol for S&P 500, and CL is the future ticker symbol for crude oil. Contract size. What is the contract size for ES? If I buy one contract, meaning I have 100 options within that contract, right? In futures, if I buy one ES contract, meaning I control $50 multiplied by S&P 500 index. For example, today, S&P 500 index is at 3400. So 3400 multiplied by 50. I have the control of $170,000 worth of contract. Right? If I buy one crude oil contract, meaning I control 1,000 barrels of crude oil. Like in stocks and options, particularly in stocks, it increases by every cent, right? If Apple price is $120.57, it increases 58, 59, 60 like that. But in ES futures, it increases by 0.25. The previous example, you see, 3423.25. Next, it will be 3423.50, 3423.75, 3423.24. It happens like that. It increases like that. And for crude oil is like stock. It increases by 1 cent. What is the dollar value of one tick? What is the dollar value of 0.25 $12.50? It's not quarter. $12.50. What is the dollar value of 1 cent increase? It's $10. What is the dollar value of 1 point? For example, the S&P 500 is 3423. Assume it is 3423. What happens to my futures contract if it increases to 3424? I'll make $50. I make a profit of $50. And in crude oil, if crude oil increases by $1, how much profit I'll make? $1,000. Right now the crude oil price is $39 approximately. If it goes to $40, what happens? I'll make a profit of $1,000. Right? That's the dollar value of 1 point. What is the notional value of each contract? If I buy ES futures contract, one contract, what is the worth of it? What is the value of it? $170,000. And if I buy one contract of crude oil, what is the value of it? It's $39,000. Have a control of this $170,000. Do I need to commit a capital of $170,000? No. There is a margin involved. So if I just pay $13,200, I can control $170,000. And similarly, for crude oil, if I just pay $9,000 approximately, I can control 1,000 barrels. What is the value of 1,000 barrels? It is $39,000. Hope you understand. We'll go to now. We understood a little bit about futures contract. Okay. Now we'll do a apple to apple comparison. Assume the SPY ETF price is $340 per share, and the futures contract for S&P 500 index is ES, and it is $3,400 per contract. Let's do a comparative study. First, let us see what is the scenario if we buy SPY ETF, 100 SPY ETF. Okay? I'm purchasing 100 shares at $340 per share. So I'm committing a total capital of $34,000. So what if SPY goes to zero, which is highly unlikely, but just for an argument's sake. If it goes to zero, I'll be losing all this $34,000. So my total risk is $34,000 in case of stock. In case of option, say for instance, I am buying a call option. The strike is $340. If the strike price is, the strike I'm buying here is 340, which is at the money. So I'm paying $7.50 per option. So one option contract contains 100 options. So $7.50 multiplied by 100. So I'm committing a capital of $750. As it is at the money, for you are aware, at the money contract will have a delta of 50 cents per share. So as I am paying only $750, what is the maximum I'm going to lose here? $750. Similarly, when SPY is at 340, the S&P 500 index is at 3400. When I buy a futures contract, one future contract is a 34. I'm buying a $3,400. Okay? So the value of one ES contract will be $170,000, but I'm going to pay only the margin of $13,200. Just paying $13,200, I'm going to control $170,000 worth of 1 year's contract, right? If S&P 500 index goes to zero, what is my maximum risk? $170,000. Let us see a scenario. What if the stock increases in value by $5? Now from this 300 and SPY, from 340, it grows to 345. So I make a $5 profit. So 5 divided by 340 multiplied by 100, I make $1.47 return on investment. But similarly, if SPY grows by $5, what will be my options value? Just pay little attention, the delta is here 0.50 per share. What does it mean? If my underlying increases by, if SPY increases by $1, my option value increases by 50 cents. If SPY increases by $2, my option value increases by $1. And if SPY increases by $5, my options value will increases by $2.50. So now my option value is increased to $7.50 to $10. What is my return on investment? $2.50, that is profit, divided by $7.50 multiplied by 100. My return on investment is 33.33%. This is with regard to option. Let us see similar scenario for futures. If SPY increases by $5, that is, if SPY increases from $340 to $345, what will happen to ES futures contract? It increases by $50. It grows from 340 to 345. This grows from 3,400 to 3,450. Right? So, what is the value of 1 point increase? $50. So $50 multiplied by 50, but is the value increase 2500. If the SPY increases by $5, and if, of course, the ES will increases by $50, then I make a profit of 2500 in futures. What is the initial capital I invested? 13200. 2000 divided by 13200, I'll make 18.93% return on investment. Now you have a comparison between stocks, options, and futures. Now you take a decision based on your own risk reward ratio. Based on your own risk reward. Okay? Now I'll give little more information about futures. What are the advantages and limitations? I have few more advantages and a couple of limitations. Let us see. In case of futures, you can trade 6 days in a week and 24 hours all through the day you can trade, except there is a break for 1 hour. Other than that, you can trade all through the day for 6 days a week. And the margin, for smaller margin, that is just for 13200, you control the huge money, right? For 100 instead of committing $170,000, you are paying margin of only 13200 and you have the control of 170,000. And in futures, you are not only dealing with stocks. There are many asset classes like agriculture products, oil and gas, foreign exchange, metals. Okay? And one more significant point in futures is there is no time decay in future. What is time decay? For example, you are buying an Apple option, one call option. There is just 1 week of expiry. It will expire in a week's time. And our options price is not moving anywhere. It stands still. Okay. It's at $120. Just a rough number. Even stock is not moving. It's not neither increasing nor decreasing. But as the time passes, every single day passes, your option value will decrease. Like any food item, if you go to a grocery store to buy a gallon of milk, if the expiry date is pretty long, its value is more. If the expiry date is, if it's going to expire tomorrow, you're not going to buy it because its value is pretty less. And same applies for options as well. Options has time decay, but in futures there is no time decay. And coming to the disadvantages side of futures, the major disadvantage I see in future is the margin, the leverage. Here, just by paying $13,200, you are controlling $170,000. This will be advantage when the SPY's price increases in your favor. Here, the SPY increases by $5, you make $2,500 profit. Think, if SPY decreases by $5, you're going to lose $2,500. Almost 25% of your margin, that is your capital, you're going to lose. That is a major limitation with regard to futures. Right? I think now you are a little clear. You understand a little better regarding futures. If you have more questions regarding futures, just comment below on this video. I'll try to answer all your questions. And please consider subscribing to this channel. Thank you, friends. Bye-bye.